Here we're going to take a look at the three main types of marabou for fly tying. The first one I have here is strung blood marabou. This marabou has even tips, has a more paintbrush kind of style stem where all the tips come to an even point. It does not have much plumage or feathers near the base at the stem, and it's also very short. I actually picked one of the longer ones here, but generally this marabou is very short, which makes it good for tails, wings, streamers. You can use it on bodies to make bodies with, but typically it's good for tailing. And strung means that it comes strung together in a clump with a little piece of string inside of there that strings it all together. The next one we're going to look at here is woolly bugger marabou. This has a thicker stem. It has plumage that goes all the way down the stem of the feather. So what you can do is you can either rip off this plumage, tie it in, or you can tie it in as a whole feather. And generally the points or the tips do come to a point as well. This feather is usually not very good for wrapping either. Just like the blood quill, it's not good for wrapping collars or wrapping around the shank of the hook just because it has this thick stem here. This is also strung together in a clump with string, and that is the woolly bugger marabou, hence the name woolly bugger. It's good for woolly buggers. Then the last one here is extra select marabou. Very long feather, the longest one in the marabou family here, and it is good for wrapping or collaring. The stem down at the base is fairly thick, but the stem where you're going to be wrapping the plumage up here is nice and thin, very pliable. This is great for spey flies, wrapping collars. You can also tear the plumage off of the stem and tie it in for woolly buggers or streamers. Any of these marabous here are fine for tying in on tails or streamers. If you pull all the material to a point here, again, they all do come to a blunt point, so you can tail with any of these marabous. It's just this is the one that you want to use for spey flies and collaring, not the woolly bugger or the strung blood marabou. And it also comes strung together in a clump as well. And that is really the basic difference between the three main types of marabou. This type of marabou comes from a turkey, so it's the larger marabou. There is other marabou out there. It's called chickaboo or mini marabou, and that comes from chickens. It's much smaller. This is all the kind of turkey family of marabou. And you can find all the marabou family and different types on our website, intheriffle.com.